promising to steal.
The sheriff.
I guess it's whether it's a truth-telling person or a lying person.
That makes sense. Those are the actions, though.
Those are actions. What they're trying to persuade the signal is what they're saying. They're saying that they're going to steal a share.
Believers or non-believers?
Yeah, I think that's... Yeah, the second player hasn't made any... Okay, so then for each one, we have... First player's honest and second player believes it, what does the payoff matrix look like?
So if the first player says that he's gonna place.
Yes. No, the first player says he's going to steal, but he's going to share it.
So this is the second game, right, essentially, that we played?
Yeah, it's with the promise to steal. So if he's being honest, and even if he believes it, but if he still steals, everybody still gets the shame. So, say,
minus one.
Which, I don't think any of the beliefs or honesty or dishonesty makes a difference on that, on any of these. Right? And does it affect the split anywhere? If both decide to split. Okay. Does it affect if the second player decides to steal? Decides to steal the second shares.
Yes.
I think there it does.
If he's honest?
If he's honest, yeah. Because if he's honest, then this is still 1-1. If he's lying, those are the same. The question is, can we fill that one in?
Will that still not just be 1-1? That's the other one? Doesn't matter if it's a non-believer.
It'd be a -1, -1, no? It depends on what the non-believer...
Doesn't matter what he believes, if the other one's honest, right? It's just 1-1.
And they still choose to split, so there's no way for the honest person to decide if there is a believer or if it's a non-believer. Right?
Oh, well, steal. He said, if you share, I will share. Or if you share, I will share the stolen cookie with you. Is that how it is? So if he steals, he won't get it. He won't share.
But that should be 1-1.
Yeah, it should be.
Yeah, right. But the first believer is false.
But it is a little tricky to think about because this person expects to get nothing if they do that, but that's not actually what their expected utility is. So
he said that this was Q and 1 minus Q, and this is P and 1 minus P.
Then we could start to figure out the X entering utility functions by just collapsing which side I'm looking at. So like if I know that I'm a believer, then I'm only looking at these options. I know that I'm honest, I'm only looking at these two tables and composing the finite gap matrix based on that. Which, if the role player knows what he is, the common player really doesn't make any difference. So you could argue that there actually is no type of second player, because it doesn't make any difference which type he is. The payoff matrix is the same. And then the X ante is just using the fact that we have a P and 1 minus P to compose a single payoff table in the end. So these should all be the same. And it would be so does that help us solve what action you should take